Hi friends, welcome to Tech Arkit YouTube channel. My name is Ravi. In this video session, we are going to see that how to interrupt boot process and get the access to the any Linux machine whenever you have a physical access to the server. Let's see this. So how you can do that. So first of all, here I have the Linux machine switched on, so I have a physical access to this machine. When I click over here, so I say that enter and I type the password over here, but unfortunately the password is wrong. So I would like to reset this password, or I would like to gain the access to the machine. I do not have the password in hand. Okay, let's do that, how we can get it. So first of all, I'm going to reboot this machine. Say restart. While machine has been restarting, so we have to press spacebar to stop over here. Okay, the kernel has been stopped over here. So here in the kernel step itself, what you can do is that, so you can simply click, you can simply say E for edit. So which means that we are going to edit this kernel lines to interrupt the boot process. So I just edited using the E and go down over here, and wherever you see that Linux 16, the line, okay, simply go to the end of that line and add rd dot break console equal to tty1. So whenever you add this one, what happens? So whenever you add this one, it says that you are entering, you are breaking this process and entering into the single user mode. By entering into the single user mode, you get the access to the that machine. So which means that you are in the single user mode, it does not ask you any username and password, it just enter into the root directly. Okay, so now just press Control X. Now the machine process would be interrupted and enter into the single user mode. Now which got into the single user mode directly, you can see that hash value over here, which means that which is into root access. Now type mount command and see that all these files has been mounted as a read only actually, so not mounts really into the read write options over here. Okay, or else you can also see that mount slash sysroot over here, which is actually already mounted and it is busy, looks like. Okay, so maybe you can grab using the sysroot. Okay, the root file system has been mounted, but which shows here it is that the sysroot is in read only. So whenever you have read only file system, you cannot edit anything. So it should be rewrite, then only you can write anything on this file system. In order to gain, or in order to convert this into the read write, just do this mount -o and remount this partition, or the remount this mount point with rewrite access slash sysroot. Now you can see that using the above command, now it is rewrite. Just convert this sysroot into the actual root using the convert chroot, in the sense change chroot slash sysroot. Now it becomes a root. Now type command called passwd, which will ask you for the new password to enter. You can now change the password over here. So the password authentication has been changed. Now you can reboot the machine, but what happens here is that the by default RHEL7 enables the SE Linux. So Without relabeling all your SE Linux policy or the context, then you cannot get the access really to the machine. So in order to gain this access and relabel all the SE Linux related stuff, then what you have to do is that you have to create an empty file in the slash so that it relabels automatically. So in order to do that, create touch slash dot auto relabel. So be careful, because if you misspell or if you do not properly create this file, you cannot get the access, or you cannot gain the access to the machine. So in order to do that, you have to be very careful whenever you are creating this file. So okay, confirm that the file has been created and exit from the process, so that whenever you do a two times exit, it logouts and it reboots the machine and it relabels all everything from the context of the SE Linux. Then it start up the machine, then you can enter into the username and password so that you will get the access. So now our PC has been turned on. Now you can go to the user and type the password. So actually reset the password called root over here and enter the password. That's it. You got into the machine. Say this. So your machine, now you are into root user. That's it. So you can simply gain this access by interrupting your kernel process whenever you have the physical access to that machine. Thanks for watching. Stay tuned. Please subscribe to the channel for more upcoming videos and courses. Please follow us on social networking sites. If you have any technical related questions, you can ask.